I'm Raul Arbeláez, and I'm the Vice President for the IIHS Vehicle Research Center. In our side crash, we have a moving deformable barrier that strikes the tested vehicle at 50 kilometers per hour. That's 31 miles per hour. And the barrier weighs 1,500 kilograms. It's about 3,300 pounds, and it represents a typical ride height and front end geometry of a pickup truck or SUV. These are types of vehicles that, in real world T-bone type crashes, do a lot of damage to other vehicles when they collide. In the vehicle, we have two dummies, one in the driver position, another in the left rear position. These dummies represent a small female and an adolescent. And in these dummies, we're collecting injury measures from the head, neck, chest, pelvis, and lower extremity regions in hopes of identifying the total injury risks to the occupant in this crash. Besides injury measures, one of the things that we look at is how good a job the side airbags do at protecting the heads from outside intruding objects like the hood of a high-riding vehicle or a tree pole or post. We also look at how good a job the occupant compartment does at holding up. How good a job does it do at resisting that intrusion? And so we measure the safety cage, how much it intrudes before and after the crash. We've come a long way since the Institute's first release of side impact crash test results in 2003. Back then, most vehicles had safety cages that allowed too much intrusion into the compartment, and side airbags were not standard safety features. When you look at what we have today, most vehicles' safety cages are very strong, limit intrusion into the compartment, and the side airbags do a really nice job of protecting the vital organ areas. As a result, we have a vehicle fleet that is much safer and does a much better job of protecting occupants in severe side crashes.